Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter study of animal tissue. In that we are studying topic structure of compact bone. Now bone isn't part of your body that every one of us have, and it provides support and structure to your body. Let's study a little bit more about bones today. Bones. Now as a child we had number of bones which were much greater as compared to adults, because after the age of 5 some of our bones fuse, and once we grow 18 years of age even few bones fuse. For example, the growth plate fuses in individuals after 18 and 21 years respectively, depending upon male and female. Now bones are basically a part of a body which provides support as well as protective covering. They're one of the part of the tissues which actually do this function. Each bone is basically enclosed, or you can say simply enveloped, by white fibrous tissues, or white fibrous connective tissues for that matter, which is termed as peristrium. Now this peristrium is the one through which your blood vessels as well as your nerve fibers, or simply you say neuronal cells or neurons or other cells of your body, perforate or perforate through this. Now whenever the cells perforate through this, the blood vessels also leak or pass through them. In the center there is a bone marrow cavity. Now the bone marrow cavity can be red or it can be yellow, and if it is yellow it is pertaining to fat molecules or fat cells, whereas the red one basically are entitled to or catered to your RBCs as well as your leukocytes. The structure of compact bones. Now whenever we study the structure of compact bones, what we notice is that each of this bone is enclosed by a layer of white fibrous connective tissue, and being enclosed by this white fibrous connective tissue, they are also called as peristrium, through which the blood vessels, whether it is capillaries, arteries or veins, as well as the nerve piercing, and when I talk about nerve I talk about the neuronal system, the neuro control system, or basically you can say the neurons, the structural unit or the structural unit that helps to pass signals at a speed of electricity. They also contain matrix which has protein ossin. In bones the matrix is basically arranged in concentric circle kind of structure. In center there is a presence of bone marrow in this bone structure that's lined by a cavity, and which is termed as endosterium. A bone is basically externally covered by thick white fibrous sheath. Now this thick white fibrous sheath basically gives that edgy or that protective layer to the brain. Marrow cavity is basically filled with soft vascular and fatty tissues, which together constitute to form bone marrow. Now this is the place where your RBCs, WBCs, platelets all go. Red marrow is highly vascular reticular tissue that forms erythrocytes and glandular leukocytes, whereas the yellow marrow is basically involved in storage of fat that's only at the time of emergency or when it is needed. Students, in this part of the chapter we came across the structure of a compact bone and how does that function and what's its working. I hope we are very clear with this concept. Thank you.